Good afternoon. As we come together in prayer, we are mindful of how Jesus feeds us all who are hungry with his very life. A special welcome to our children who are receiving their first communion this weekend and to their families. The back-to-school supply drive sponsored by the St. Vincent de Paul Society for Families in Need is this weekend. You can leave your school supplies on the tables in the gathering area.
Good afternoon. Today is the 18th Sunday of Ordinary Time. Please rise and turn toward the center aisle, recognizing one another as the body of Christ.
Gentle Jesus, risen Lord, we come to table. With our hearts so full of joy,
we come to your table. We come to your table. We come to your table.
Gather at the table of the Lord in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. My sisters and brothers, may the grace and peace of God our Father and our Lord Jesus Christ, who feeds us with his love, be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Welcome, everyone. Special welcome to any guests we have with us tonight, and certainly the families of those who come to the table tonight for the first time, our children who are receiving their first communion tonight. Boys and girls, we are just so excited and happy and proud to walk with you to the table of the Lord to receive this great gift. And so Olivia and Sophia and Noah and Jack and Lauren, feel the love. Feel the love that God has for you. Feel the love that all of us have for you. And let's come with open hearts to a God who loves us more than we could ever imagine, so much that he comes to live in our hearts. Lord Jesus, you multiplied loaves and fish to feed the multitudes. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are the source of strength and nourishment for our hungry souls. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are the way that leads to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let's give glory to God. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Draw near to your servants, O Lord, and answer their prayers with unceasing kindness, that for those who glory in you as their creator and guide, you may restore what you have created and keep safe what you have restored. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, all you who are thirsty, come to the water. You who have no money, come, receive grain and eat. Come without paying and without cost, drink wine and milk. Why spend your money for what is not bread, your wages for what fails to satisfy? Heed me, and you shall eat well. You shall delight in rich fare. Come to me heedfully. Listen, that you may have life. I will renew with you the everlasting covenant, the benefits assured to David. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The hand of the Lord feeds us. He answers all our needs.
The hand of the Lord feeds us. He answers all our needs.
The Lord is gracious and merciful, slow to anger and of great kindness. The Lord is good to all and compassionate toward all his works.
The hand of the Lord feeds us. He answers all our needs.
The eyes of all look hopefully to you, and you give them their food in due season. You open your hand and satisfy the desire of every living thing. The hand of the Lord feeds us. He answers all our needs. The Lord is just in all his ways and holy in all his works. The Lord is near to all who call upon him. To all who call upon him in truth. The hand of the Lord feeds us. He answers all our needs. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, what will separate us from the love of Christ? Will anguish or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness, or peril, or the sword? No, in all these things, We conquer overwhelmingly through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor present things, nor future things, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus, our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
One does not live on bread alone, but on every word that comes forth from the mouth of God.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When Jesus heard of the death of John the Baptist, he withdrew in a boat to a deserted place by himself. The crowds heard of this and followed him on foot from their towns. When he disembarked and saw the vast crowd, his heart was moved with pity for them, and he cured their sick. When it was evening, the disciples approached him and said, "This is a deserted place, and it is already late. Dismiss the crowds so that they can go into the villages and buy food for themselves." Jesus said to them, "There is no need for them to go away. Give them some food yourselves." But they said to him, "Five loaves and two fish are all that we have here." Then he said, "Bring them here to me." And he ordered the crowds to sit down on the grass. Then, taking the five loaves and the two fish, and looking up to heaven, he said the blessing, broke the loaves, and gave them to the disciples, who in turn gave them to the crowds. They all ate and were satisfied. And they picked up the fragments left over, 12 wicker baskets full. And those who ate were about 5,000 men, not counting women and children. The Gospel of the Lord. So I thought tonight maybe we could play a little Bible trivia. What do you think? Just in case they ever bring back that game, Trivial Pursuit. You remember that? How many remember that game? I haven't heard about that in a long time. I was never very good at that, but it was kind of a fun game. Or maybe someday you'll get chosen to be on Jeopardy. Did you ever hear of Jeopardy? Oh, it's a tough game show. Okay? So, here's the topic. Bible. And here's what we're asking. The one and only story of Jesus' miracles that appears in all four Gospels. Pretend you're on Jeopardy. Anybody want to take a stab at the answer? Anybody? Olivia? What do you think? What's the one story of Jesus' miracles that's in all four Gospels. What do you think, Sophia? Anybody want to take a stab at it? Noah? Where's Jack? Jack, what do you think? Anybody? Dad? Feeding the large crowds with the fish and the loaves. Sorry, I cannot accept that. It has to be in the form of a question. But you're right. But you're right. The story we just heard, interestingly enough, of all the different stories of Jesus' miracles and the great things that he did, that's the only story that is found in all four Gospels, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. And I think, for me at least, it says, I wonder why that is. We believe that the Gospels are inspired by God, and somehow the Gospel writers, all four of them, were inspired to include that story, maybe some little different twists in it, but that basic story in their Gospel. And I don't think the answer is a matter of trivia. I think the answer is obviously very important, at least seems very important to God. And here's where I think in general the answer is, because I think God wanted to use this story of the multiplication of the loaves and the fish, feeding of thousands of people, to teach some really important lessons. So I just want to pull out a couple of those lessons that I'm hearing that I think are really important. First of all, crowds of people wanted to be with Jesus. And I'm thinking to myself, did Jesus want to be with them, or did they want to be with the people, want to be with Jesus? And the answer is, well, both. But really, if you heard the story tonight, they were looking for Jesus. And Jesus was probably going through a really tough time in his life. He just heard about the death of John the Baptist, and so I'm sure he was really brokenhearted. And you know what it's like sometimes when you say, I just got to get away. I just got to be by myself. I just got to go, you know, deal with this or pray or whatever it is that would help. And all of a sudden, all these thousands of people figured out where he was going and they went there because they needed him. Now, I'm not sure how you think you would have handled that if you were the Lord. I have a feeling I know I might have said, will you people please leave me alone? I just need a little time here. I'll deal with you some other time or go figure this out. That's not the way Jesus is. He just kind of dropped his own needs for a while, and his heart was moved with compassion. He was so glad the people were there. He wanted to do what he could for them. And that's the lesson of why we're here and why Jesus is with us. Yeah, we come, but Jesus knows our hearts. And although he was going through a difficult time, he knew they were too, just like us sometimes. Whether it's in our personal lives or things that might be going on or this whole pandemic of not knowing what's going on, what it is, Jesus is basically saying, come. They obviously heard the prophet Isaiah that we heard in the first reading today. Come, everybody. Come, all you who are thirsty. And I will give you to drink. I will help you. I will give you my heart as a gift. So that's the first lesson I hear. The second lesson, I'm going to give you a little trivia question again, okay? There were 5,000, it says 5,000 men, not counting women and children. I'm not sure why they didn't count the women and children. I think they were hungry too, right? Wouldn't you think? I would think. So there were gobs of people there. And I doubt that they all knew each other. Just like us, we don't have that many people here, but we don't all know each other. But what was the one thing that I think was common to everybody there? Rick, what do you think? They were all hungry. Good answer. Because if they weren't hungry, they probably would have gone home or gone somewhere else or gone to the mall or shopping or to a movie or whatever. They were hungry. And Jesus obviously knew that. And the disciples, they were a little overwhelmed with that thought. Like, here's thousands of people hungry. We could have a riot on our hands. Let's get rid of these people. Why don't you all go and find something to eat? Head down to McDonald's or to wherever you want to go, but take care of yourselves. And Jesus said, no, that's not the way I deal with it. Gather them together. That's the message. Jesus wants to gather his people together and promises to feed us. And one of the things that all of us know for sure is that you really cannot enjoy the meal unless you're hungry. You probably won't even show up if you're hungry, if you're not hungry. But if you're hungry, and the hungrier you are, the better, that's when we come to satisfy that deep hunger within. These people were not only physically hungry, it was the end of the day and they didn't have anything to eat. They were spiritually hungry. And that's why they came. And I hope that's what brings us. We may not be physically hungry. You may have had something to eat before you came, or you're going out to dinner afterwards. But it's our souls, our spirits, that are hungering for the Lord. And that's what unites us. And that's what keeps us coming to God. That hunger for God's love that he gives us, especially in the Eucharist. And then the third lesson that I think this story, this miracle story is all about, was obviously Jesus was preparing his people for the greatest miracle of all, the Eucharist. It's a miracle what we're celebrating tonight. Sometimes we just kind of take it for granted. So, oh, it's just Mass. It's not just Mass. It's a miracle. And I want you to listen for these words tonight, okay? All they had was a few loaves and a couple of fish. Jesus said, whatever you have, bring it to me. Whatever you have, bring it to me. And then he took those gifts. He blessed them. Means he thanked God for them. Thanks, God, for everything you give us. It may seem like no big deal, just a few loaves and a couple of fish, but they're giving it all to you. Then he broke them, and he gave them 5 loaves, 2 fish, 10,000 people, 12 baskets left over. Go figure. That's what a miracle is all about. It's not magic. It's God's love. It's God's power. It's God's grace when we're willing to give whatever we have. And I believe that that's the biggest reason why all 4 Gospels and we tonight need to hear that story. Because it's all about the Eucharist. And tonight, all the rest of us are so blessed to be reminded of that by beautiful children like Olivia and Sophia and Noah and Jack and Lauren. Thank you for reminding us that tonight God's going to do a miracle for us. He's going to take our simple gifts of bread and wine. He's going to take them, bless them, break them, and give them to us. And it's the greatest gift of his love, the gift of Jesus. So get real hungry. Get real hungry, because the Lord has come to answer all our needs and to feed us. Let's profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became human. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, suffered and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Nothing in this world can separate us from the love of Christ. Confidently, we bring our prayers before the God of mercy.
For the church, that disciples of Jesus may distribute the bread of life to all who hunger, sharing generously with others all that the Lord so graciously shares with us, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the world, that people of differing cultures may recognize our common humanity as we sit down together at the banquet of life, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our parish community, for those who staff our food pantry, for those who support our St. Vincent de Paul endeavors, and for those who offer assistance through Gabriel's wings, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those gathered here, that we strive to become the Eucharist for others, especially those whose lives have fallen in despair, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our sick, for those who are living with serious illness or constant pain, for those who feel isolated in their illness, and for those who cannot afford adequate health care, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our children receiving their first communion this weekend, that they will always stay close to Jesus and receive him each week in the Eucharist, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died and now rest and rejoice in God's kingdom of peace and glory, including David Weaver, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. Merciful God, so great is your love for us that nothing can come between us except sin. Accept our prayers. Help us to remain strong in faith, hope, and love, that we may delight in the rich fare of the heavenly banquet. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, who will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ. Humble himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, that will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
With humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, O Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Lord, wash away my iniquities and cleanse me from all my sins. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours will be pleasing and acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at our hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Graciously sanctify these gifts, O Lord, we pray, in accepting the oblation of this spiritual sacrifice, make of us an eternal offering to you through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being. And while in this body we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration, we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread. And giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and all who serve your church. Remember David Weaver and all of our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. We gather at God's table as the one family of God. So at the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. My friends, may the peace of the Lord be with you always. And from our hearts, let us offer each other a sign of the Lord's peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my roof. Only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. Olivia and Sophia, Jack, Lauren, and Noah, tonight the Lord is inviting you to come with us to his table for this greatest miracle of all. This is really Jesus who comes now to live in your heart and to bring you all his love.
Please be seated.
Let us pray. Accomplish with constant protection, O Lord. Accompany with constant protection, O Lord, those you renew with these heavenly gifts, and in your never-failing care for them, make them worthy of eternal redemption through Christ our Lord. Amen. Thanks, everyone, for sharing in this celebration. Thank you for sharing your faith in Christ, especially with the children who came to the Eucharist for the first time tonight. And certainly Olivia and Sophia and Jack and Lauren and Noah, we are just so happy for you and pray that this will be just the beginning of experiencing how good God is and allowing him to continue to come into your hearts in every way. You know, I often wondered, after those thousands of people were fed with a few loaves and a couple of fish, I wonder if they just went back to business as usual, or if it changed their lives somehow and they became real followers of Christ. We never know the rest of the story, only for us. So I know a lot of times children receive religious articles at First Communion time. Any of you bring anything to get blessed tonight? If you do, hold it, and if not, I'm going to bless you. That's the most important thing. So to bless something means to give thanks to God for the articles that you have, but for you, and to ask God to use them to bring his goodness, his love, and the gift of faith to others. So loving God, bless these children who have come to your table for the first time tonight, for the religious articles that they bring to you, for their parents, grandparents, and families, that they may continue to grow in your love. Help them to use these articles as ways of growing in faith and helping others to know how wonderful you are. We ask your blessing upon them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. So everyone, have a great week. Thanks for all the ways that you bring Christ to others. Let's ask the Lord now to bless all of us. The Lord be with you. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever. Our celebration is ended. Let us go in peace, glorifying God by our lives.
Thanks be to God.
God has done. Sing out to every nation. Go sing the stories to everyone. Go out in peace and justice, walking in God's light. Go out and love as one, proclaim the risen Christ. Go out to all creation and tell wonders of God has done. Sing out to every nation. Go sing the stories to everyone. Go out in love and kindness, share the living word. Go out to heal the sick and preach to all the world. Go out to all creation and tell the wonders of God has done. Sing out to every nation. Go sing the stories to everyone. Go out with hope and pardon, forgiving those who stray. Go out and speak the truth that mercy is God's way. Go out to all creation and tell the wonders of God has done. Sing out to every nation. Go sing the stories to everyone. Go out in joy and beauty, peacefully depart. Go out and sing of Christ who dwells within your heart. Go out to all creation and tell the wonders our God has done. Sing out to every nation. Go sing the stories to everyone.